Hey folks, welcome to the channel. Today's episode, we're going to continue the mosaic Bowie that we started in the last build. If you haven't watched that, I'll put a link up in the corner. Go watch that first about building the mosaic. In this episode, we're going to turn that billet into a knife. The first thing I got to do is grind off all the sacrificial steel that I used to hold the mosaic together. I would normally do this with an angle grinder, but my wife is on an important phone call, so I didn't want to make a lot of noise. Okay, she's done. Time to make this go a little faster. After I got the majority of the mild steel off with the angle grinder, I took it to the surface grinder just to get it nice and flat on both sides. So here's the billet, all ground, surface ground. It's just a hair under a quarter inch thick, but it's nice and flat now. I've etched it. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's etched. It looks amazing. Now, let's put the profile on it. So I'm just gonna put it about there. And then, I annealed this, so hopefully it's pretty easy to cut. I'm gonna do most of this on the bandsaw. Okay. This was pretty easy to cut with the bandsaw. I also saved a bunch of these pieces, and you'll see why later when I do the heat treat. I'm just grinding the profile and getting it all nice and shaped. You'll notice this was mostly a stock removal project after the billet was formed. That's because I don't want to distort the pattern by trying to forge in bevels or anything like that. You never want to do that with a mosaic. I know some of you may be sick of hearing it, but I love this grinder. Upgrading to the Broadbeck has been one of the best decisions I've made in a while. I thought I could do this radius with the small wheel. It ends up being a little too large for this, so I have to go to a file afterwards. After looking at the knife, I was thinking it was just a little too thick. I don't like big, heavy, thick knives. So I wanted to take this back to the surface grinder and take a little bit off it. It ends up more around 3/16, which is more what I think it should be for this knife.
So I've got it resurface ground to a better thickness. It's probably 3/16 around there. So that's kind of what I wanted. I'm gonna put some marking lines on here. I wanna do the false edge now. And then, then do the bevel.
Doing the false edge is kind of time consuming. Probably took me over an hour, close to an hour and a half to do both sides. But this is what I find the most accurate. Trying to do it on the grinder, it's just too easy to screw it up.
I also find it a lot better to do the false edge before you do your bevel, because you want that top false edge to taper perfectly to the tip. You can do that by controlling your bevel when you get close to the tip of the knife. This part, the free grinding of the bevel, this is definitely the hardest part and takes the most practice. That's what everyone wants to be able to do. Guys, there's no excuse, just you gotta put in the time and practice. This is just the initial bevel before heat treat. So this one, I'll usually keep it between a quarter and a half inch from where I want it to be. I'll do the rest as part of the final grind after the heat treat.
All right, we got the initial grinding done, false edge is done. It looks pretty good. Now, time for some normalization and then heat treat.
The blade's already gone through three normalization cycles at 1600, 1450, and 1250. Now for the quench. Like always, I check for warps first. You got all the time in the world to check if it's hard. Here I'm using a 65 HRC file to test to see how hard it is. Now it's going in my steel plate setup so it stays straight during the temper.
What I'm gonna do now is I've got a couple of extra pieces in there from the same billet, just cutoffs. I've done this whole normalization cycle exactly the same as the blade. I'm going to quench those and do a snap test on them just to see what the grain structure is like. Well, I forgot to turn the camera on for the actual snap, but you can see the grain pattern is pretty fine, especially on these two here. It's very powdery, and that's what you want. I can see the grains in the Damascus here, which is interesting and to be expected, but pretty good grain structure. There's another shot. The bottom one looks a little gray because I touch it with my finger and I got some grease on it, but you can see there, the inside looks like flour, not sugar, which is really good.
Here I'm just using the surface grinder and a 120 grit belt just to do the flats. On this knife, since the blade is kind of thick, I decided to mill down the tang so that there's a shelf that the guard is going to sit against, so it will be nice and flush. Now it's time for final grinding and bringing this thing down to a really tight edge. I'm also going to bring the bevel up towards the spine, probably within about a quarter inch of the spine. Here's everyone's favorite part, the hand sanding. Green Beetle once did a video of 1 hour of hand sanding, which I actually thought was pretty funny. Not that I watched the whole thing. My hand sanding regimen is to start at 220, 400, 800, 1000. I also change direction by 45 degrees at every grit. One thing that I've been doing lately is changing the angle between the flats and the bevel, and that actually brings out your line quite a bit, so I've been doing that one as well.
Okay, folks, here it is after some hand sanding. This is down to 220, so I'll take it probably to 800 before I fit the guard. But I like how it's turned out. It's got nice lines, nice crisp lines on it so far. Yeah. So in the next episode, we're going to take this, which is a piece of the same Damascus from this, and forge that out a little bit, and that's going to be our guard. So we're going to be milling the slot for that, fitting that, getting the handle on it. Haven't decided what handle wood I'm going to use, but we'll check that out in the next episode. We'll also, of course, etch this baby. All right, guys, thanks for joining. We'll see you on the next one.